Does anyone really know the first song ever made? Archaeologists have uncovered primitive flutes that go back 43,000 years. But I don't want to start here. I want to start when music really took off. Hi, my name is Andrew, and I'll be talking about the evolution of music. We begin in the 18th century, where most people know Mozart was most popular. He received his musical education when he was just 4 years old, and when he turned 8, he wrote his first symphony. The Mozart Family Grand Tour began when he was 7, and when you think of how long a tour would last with your favourite artist right now, you might think that it would last a few months. But did you know that his tour lasted 3 years? Mozart made his last symphony when he was 32 years old. It was symphony number 41, and it was about 25 minutes long. He died 3 years later, at the age of 35. Let's fast forward to the next century. What does music sound like now? Sounds kind of familiar, don't you think? Well, what if I told you that this was the century when the first ever sound was recorded? In 1857, nearly two decades before the first phone call, a man by the name of Edward Leon Scott invented the phon autograph and recorded a woman singing. Prepare yourself, it might creep you out. That noise right there was a woman singing the song Au Clair de la Lune. Someone has managed to restore the sound to make it sound a bit better, but to me it sounds still a bit terrifying. Composing music was still the most popular genre at this time, and Beethoven would have to be the most famous. Here's an example of one of his songs. The music in the 19th century is often called the Romantic period because composers sought out to make music more emotional and dramatic. They were inspired by nature and poetry. An example of one of these composers is Beethoven. Beethoven and Mozart are perhaps the most famous composers of all time. Beethoven is a very important part of the evolution of music, as he was a crucial figure during the transition between classical and romantic music. We've now reached the 20th century, and in this century, music completely changed. New genres of music were made, and new instruments were being used. Ragtime music became very popular in the early 1900s. Here's what it would sound like. Jazz is another genre of music that became popular in the 20th century. In 1917, the very first jazz song was ever made. They originally called it Jazz, as in J-A-S-S, but it was renamed later that year to Jazz. At this point in time, movies and musicals were beginning to get more traction, and as their popularity went up, so did music's. You can't have a movie or a musical without music. World War II influenced music in a big way. It was the first big conflict happening in the age of electronically mass distributed music. Multiple pro-war and anti-war songs were made, and music was used as propaganda because it was easy to influence people and it was widespread. Jazz music provided comfort for families at home and for soldiers abroad, and even some musicians were drafted into the military, but they took their music with them. And they even formed some military jazz bands, and this helped to boost morale of the other soldiers around them. Most people listened to the radio at this time, but more families were able to afford a phonograph. Did you know that the radio censored a lot of music during the 40s, and this made people boycott the radio stations? and the radio stations almost moved entirely to talking because of this. In 1958, the very first annual Grammy Awards took place. Frank Sinatra was nominated for 6 awards, but didn't win any of them. The record of the year went to Domenico Modugno.
Penso che un sogno così non ritorni mai più. Mi dipingevo le mani e la faccia di blu.
As the years went on, music became more technological and different sounds were being used. By this time, songs began to have their own dedicated video. In 1981, MTV played the first ever music video on their network.
I heard you on the wireless back in 52, lying awake intently tuning in on you. If I was young, it didn't stop you coming through.
That song is called Video Killed the Radio Star by the Buggles. And other popular songs from the 80s include... Lastly, we move on to the 21st century. What does music sound like now? At this point in time, music is at its most profitable stage. Music has a lot of variety now, and it's played almost everywhere, and musicians can promote their music online or anywhere at all. Now, to end the podcast, here are some music fun facts. Musicians have a shorter lifespan than the general population. In 2016, Mozart sold more CDs than Beyoncé. Finland has the most metal bands per capita. An astronaut actually released an album and every song was actually recorded in space. Music actually helps plants grow faster. Now, hopefully these music fun facts have helped your knowledge of music even more. Thanks for listening.